Assalamu alaikum. The topic that we're going to talk on today is three simple tips for getting along with your in-laws. I received several calls, emails, and messages asking the one question which we all had to deal with sometime or the other in our lives. The question is how to get over the issues of in-laws. I believe prevention is better than cure. It's not new to say that health of any relationship is dependent on the ability to effectively communicate. And the relationships with in-laws are no different. The ability for in-laws to effectively communicate with each other is crucial to easing that transition and developing a positive relationship that can last. Once again, my favorite author, Gary Chapman, comes to the rescue. Gary Chapman writes in his book, Happily Ever After, when two people marry, they don't simply marry each other. They marry into extended families consisting of mother-in-law, father-in-law, and perhaps sister-in-law and brother-in-law. These in-laws come with a history of family traditions and ways of relating to one another. Whatever else we say about families, we can agree that all families are different. These families often lead to adjustment difficulties. The difficulties, though, don't have to last. How can you make sure you are building rather than burning bridges every time you talk to your in-laws? Therefore, Gary Chapman suggests mastering the art of communication with these simple tools. Now, my dear brothers and sisters, you need to listen very carefully. The first point is the art of listening. Most of us have not been trained to listen. Consequently, we often misunderstand our in-laws. Chapman breaks down effective listening into 5 steps. So it's art of listening broken into 5 steps. The first step is ask questions. Asking questions that show you are sincerely interested in their answers yields far better results than simply assuming you know why they do what they do. Second, step number 2. Don't interrupt. While it's tempting to want to finish their sentences or jump in when they say something you don't think is true, interrupting will only harm your relationship. The purpose of listening is to understand, not make your point. So this leads us to point number 3. Step number 3. Clarify meaning. Be sure to take the time to ask additional questions and understand exactly what they are saying. Step number 4. Express appreciation. Affirming statements do not mean that you necessarily agree what your in-laws have said. Once you have completed these first 4 steps, and especially after you have thanked them for sharing their perspective, you are in a far better place to go on to step 5. So remember, express your appreciation. Once you have done this, move on to step 5. Share your perspective. Everyone has their own perspective in a situation, and yours is just as valid as theirs. Because you listened, you are far more likely to be listened to. Because you have not interrupted, you are less likely to be interrupted. Because you have clarified meaning, your in-laws are more likely to clarify meaning. Because you have expressed appreciation, they are more likely to express appreciation to you. And together, you can accept your differences and find healthy solutions. So remember, the first one was art of listening and follow the 5 steps. Now we come to point number 2, the art of speaking for yourself. In the heat of the moment, it can be easy to put the blame on your in-laws. You always do this, or you never do that. But Chapman suggests taking a 180-degree turn and learning the art of speaking for yourself. When we begin a sentence with you, we are speaking as though we have ultimate knowledge of a person. In reality, we have only a perception. Such statements come across as condemning and will likely stimulate a defensive response from our in-laws. We end up in a major argument and both of us go away resenting the other. If you begin a statement with I, you are reporting or revealing your feelings. He continues, if you begin the statement with you, it is an attack. You statements are like verbal grenades, which bring hurt, resentment, and often counter-attacks. I statements reveal a problem without condemning the other person. While it may be difficult to make this change in your speech patterns, mastering the skill can reap great benefits in your relationship with your in-laws. Now we come to point number three, the art of negotiation. This is the most important. Healthy in-law relationships require negotiation for one simple reason. We are all humans. Chapman explains, humans think and experience different emotions and reactions. Without negotiation, we allow our differences to become more divisive. When you learn how to effectively negotiate, you can build bridges with your in-laws and create opportunities to work together. We cannot force our in-laws to do what we believe is the right thing. We can and should make requests of them. If we have desires, these desires should be verbalized. He also explains good relationships are fostered by requesting and giving, not by demanding. Above all, a successful in-law relationship requires a foundation of love and respect for each other. Remember, love is not a feeling. Chapman notes, love is an attitude, a way of thinking, and a way of behaving. Love is an attitude that says, I choose to look out for your interest. How may I help you? A loving attitude leads to loving behavior. When you continue to reach out in love to your in-laws, they will recognize that pattern and will likely respond in kind. And in-law relationships are too foundational to the strength of a marriage and family to not invest in. Positive in-law relationships are one of life's greatest assets, Chapman concludes. Living in harmony, encouraging and supporting each other in our individual pursuits help all of us reach our potential for God and good in the world. And I totally support this view. From my personal experiences, positive in-law relationships are one of life's greatest assets. Alhamdulillah. We are Muslims. And as Muslims, we have been taught the same principle by our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to practice what we preach. The Holy Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, do not ever sever your relationship with a member of your family, even if he severs his relationship with you, which also applies to your extended family and your in-laws. I hope you've all benefited from my video. Please do not forget to subscribe to my channel and press the bell icon if you would like to be notified for my future videos. Have a blessed day. Assalamu alaikum.